Mr. Grosso.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. Today, along with my colleagues, council members Allen, Nadeau, Silverman, Che, and you, Chairman Mendelson, I am reintroducing the Citizens Fair Election Program Amendment Act of 2015. As we all know, campaign donations are a necessary, though sometimes complicated, aspect of politics. Support for candidates in the District of Columbia today generally come from three sources: friends of a candidate who know his or her qualifications and support their aspirations for democracy and the common good, citizens who have views on governance and public policy, or citizens with grievances with governance, and individuals with commercial interests that either benefit or risk loss due to decisions of governance. All of these sources, in my opinion, are appropriate in a functioning democracy. The situation we face today is that we are out of balance. Big donors outweigh the ability of others to influence campaigns. The appropriate solution is to strike a balance by ensuring that everyone, regardless of whether or not they contribute or the size of their respective contribution, has an opportunity to participate in and positively influence the political process. Today, I'm asking the District of Columbia Council to step up like Maine, Connecticut, Arizona, Seattle, and North Carolina and pass a law that embraces citizen-funded elections. My bill, the Citizens Fair Elections Program Amendment Act, helps restore some balance. It would create a new independent office at the Board of Ethics and Government Accountability to provide robust oversight of campaign finance laws and public financing of elections. Campaign finance is and should be considered an ethical issue, so the creation of this new office ensures that violations of our campaign finance laws will be swiftly enforced. Further, the bill provides public dollar matches for campaign donations to candidates of $100 or less at 5-to-1 ratio, and it would require candidates to meet a certain threshold of small donations from D.C. residents in order to qualify to receive public financing. This legislation will allow candidates to rely less on big donors, resulting in more individual giving, small amounts of money in campaigns, and in turn it will help to boost civic engagement as people get more excited about candidates and help to hold candidates accountable to the constituents they are seeking to serve. This is about amplifying the voices of everyday District of Columbia residents. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I yield the remainder of my time to my co-introducers, and I welcome all and any co-sponsors.